morning.
Good morning.
Please join in singing our opening hymn number 669, We Gather Together. Please stand.
We gather together to ask the Lord's blessing. He chases and makes his will to reign known. The wicked oppressing now cease from distressing. Sing praises to his name. He forgets.
Lord, Almighty, ever-living God, grant that we may always conform our will to yours, and serve your majesty in sincerity of heart, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
In those days, Amalek came and waged war against Israel. Moses therefore said to Joshua, pick out certain men, and tomorrow go out and engage Amalek in battle. I will be standing on top of the hill with the staff of God in my hand. So Joshua did as Moses told him. He engaged Amalek in battle after Moses had climbed to the top of the hill with Aaron in tow. As long as Moses kept his hands raised up, Israel had the better of the fight. But when he let his hands rest, Amalek had the better of the fight. Moses' hands, however, were tied, so they put a rock in place for him to sit on. Meanwhile, Aaron and Hur supported his hands, one on one side and one on the other, so that his hands remained steady till sunset. After Joshua mowed down Amalek and his people with the edge of his sword. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, remain
of mind or deed, because you know from what you learn, and that from infancy you have known the sacred scriptures, which are capable of giving you wisdom for salvation. Through faith in Christ Jesus, all scripture is inspired by God, and is useful for teaching, for refutation, for correction, and for training in righteousness, so that one who belongs to God may be competent, equipped for every good work. I charge you in the presence of God and of Christ Jesus, who will judge the living and the dead, and by his appearing in his kingdom's house, proclaim the word. Be persistent whether it is convenient or inconvenient. Convenient, recommend, and encourage through all patience and teaching. The word of the Lord.
Yeah, brothers and sisters, how are you today?
Yes.
We are blessed indeed. And So, and the two of them, the morning and evening, if I don't say them out of carelessness, it's a matter for me to go to confession. Because it is a duty entrusted to me, and it is to pray for the whole world and to pray for the church. Now, one day, when I was still a student in Rome, can you hear me well?
Yes.
So I went to see my professor, the moderator of my dissertation, a doctoral dissertation. You know, a lot of people, they will finish the coursework, but they can't do the dissertation because they have fallout from their thesis director, their moderator or something. Or that they couldn't do it. So anyway, I was having a hard time because I would write something and he would say, this is not good enough. So I was getting frustrated. So anyway, then I began to pray and ask St. Catherine to pray for me. Because I was writing on her. She's a mystic. And you know, she did. And my ideas began to flow better. I'll read the work and you will read it fast. And you said, this is so good. What happened? So anyway, I knew the secret. Then the climax, the day I came to see him, I had finished writing. And he washed me down from head to toe. He was yelling, you know, calling me all sorts of names. So anyway, I was mad. And the instinct in me is to just leave, to say, who do you think you are? You are a priest and I am a priest. And ban the door and go my way. Or just give him back in the same words. But I felt that, but I remember that there is a weapon greater than human weapon. I think I have to stop here. Well, but that weapon is prayer. And I did. I was praying Cain-Miller inside, quietly in my heart. By the time he exhausted himself, I said, I have calmed down. I said, thank you. Not only you want my work to be wonderful, you want me also to be a good Christian man. That was not what he expected. So, guess what happened? From that time on, his attitude changed. He began to call me, as they say in Italian language, dottore. Dottore means doctor. Because for him, he said, you have finished. You ran the race to finish. But it's not me, it's the power of prayer. So when you feel that all hope is lost, that you need to give up, don't give up. And ask the mother of Jesus to pray with you and for you. Amen.
Amen.
They will rise. I believe in one God.
God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, there
going to do not the prayer of the faithful now, we'll do the prayer of the faithful after. We're going to do the prayer of anointing, so that any of us who wants to be anointed can come forward and stand around the altar. You can stand behind other people. And the rite is going to take two forms. There will be first the imposition of hand, invocation of the Holy Spirit, and then oil will go on the temple here and on your two palms. And here you have something that is not too tight, but if you do, it will be just here and your palms. Lord God, you have said to us through the Apostle James, is there anyone sick among you? Let them call for the priests of the church, and let the priests pray over them, anointing them all in the name of the Lord. The prayer of faith will save the sick persons, and if they have committed any sins, their sins will be forgiven them. Lord, we therefore entrust to your loving hand your sons and daughters who are sick. We ask for healing, and we ask this with confidence. For you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Those who want to be anointed can come forward, the rest will sit. Thank you.
Then the Lord will free you from sin, save you, and raise you up. Amen. Through this holy anointing, may the Lord in his mercy and love help you with the grace of the Holy Spirit. May the Lord free you from sin, save you, and raise you up. Through this holy anointing,